there may be a killer on the run. There are many unanswered questions after three men are found dead at a Cobb County country club. We know one of the victims is the club's golf pro, Gene Siller. Thank you for being with us this evening. I'm Jennifer Bellamy.
And I'm Ron Jones. Paula Searle joins us live right now as we learn new information about the victims. Paula.
Yeah, police have yet to identify the third victim or who fired the shots, but those are just two of many questions on people's minds right now. Neighbors we spoke to that live in the area, they say they're shocked that this happened in such a quiet neighborhood.
It was five. It was like boom, 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 boom.
Flowers and an American flag sit on the 10th hole of Pine Tree Country Club, where witnesses say someone drove this white pickup truck here Saturday afternoon. According to police, when Gene Siller, the golf pro at the club, went to check on what happened, he was shot in the head and killed. Tonight, we're learning the father of two, who was also the director of golf here, was originally from Cincinnati, Ohio.
A really nice guy, greeted everyone, treated everyone with respect, you know. Really good guy.
Police say when they began investigating Siller's death, they found the bodies of two other men dead from apparent gunshot wounds on the bed of the pickup truck. Only one has been identified as of Monday night. He was 76-year-old Paul Pearson. Police say he owned the truck. A family friend says Pearson lives out of town and was in Atlanta on a business trip. As of Monday night, there are no arrests.
For this to happen so close to home, I grew up in this city, and it's just mind-blowing to me.
Now, I reached out to Pearson's family. They're asking for privacy at this time until more information is released. As for Siller's family, the country club is expected to release a statement on behalf of them. Jennifer?
Paula, a lot of questions. Thank you so much. We are working hard to get more information about this case. Look for the latest updates with 11 Alive on air and on 11alive.com.